This 26 Sports High School football presentation is being brought to you exclusively by Cadillac Casting Incorporated.
All right, Ogemaw Heights ran their first play of the fourth quarter. A little swing pass out to the far side. Ogemaw Heights in the white uniforms moving left to right across your television screen. Cadillac in the blue uniforms, gold numbers, gold trim, flat blue helmets. But second and 10, no gain on that play.
Don't forget, football fans, that this game and the last two home games and this game can be viewed on
11:25, clock running.
Looks like we've got inches, or we gained inches. I've got to be looking the other way. I've got the Falcons moving the wrong way.
Ostrander under center, handoff, that counterplay coming over near side.
Look like Vikings have shut them down twice. Back-to-back.
Back-to-back plays right there. No gain after a first down play to end the third quarter. I'm telling you what, that the breeze that's coming in these windows up here feels dynamite.
You know, who would have thought that we would have been watching a game on such a beautiful night? And yes, the breeze is welcome.
Pitch over far side, trying to gain some yardage. He's down to the 40, 35, 30, 25, where he finally goes out of bounds. Give him right around the 25-yard line, a big Van Gotham, the ball carrier.
That was a good run by Cody.
Big run right there, one of their best runs of the night. It gives him a first down. 10:03, clock rolling, Ogemaw Heights.
Yep, we're halfway into Viking territory. You know, we've seen him here once before.
Yep, ball will sit at the 25-yard line. They did have one chance earlier on, and they weren't able to convert.
Right.
Ostrander under center takes the hand or takes the snap, drops back, looking far side. The ball was thrown out of bounds. No flags on the play. Falls incomplete. It'll bring up second and 10.
You know, it's good to see him making the attempt. And the only way they're going to get past the Viking line is by throwing the football. But at the same time, you got to connect with your receivers if you're going to make any headway.
So 9:16, clock rolling. Ogemaw Heights shifting players in and out of the game. Cadillac's defense trying to stiffen up here. Ball sitting right on their 25-yard line. Ostrander under center, one back behind him, one wing to the near side. Ostrander will come around, pitched it. It's a fumble on the play. Cadillac recovers, and just an endless supply of bullets to shoot themselves in the foot tonight.
Ends the beginnings of a good run for the Falcons. Gave the ball back to the Vikings.
Big play right there. Cadillac will take the ball over. Just kind of a miscommunication. I'm not sure what they were trying to run. It looked like they were trying to run an option to the near side, and it all went awry really quick. And just like that, Cadillac has the ball back, and Ogemaw Heights' scoring threat is over.
You know, we started this game. It was 76 degrees. Temperatures dropped all of 12. We're down to 64 degrees, and it's finally getting comfortable. It's going to be good sleeping weather this evening.
I concur. Hand off right up the middle. Brooks got smacked after the play. He draws a flag there. I mean, he really got rocked after the play. He looks to be fine. He's walking right there. Not sure. It's going to be a personal foul. We know that.
Mm-hmm.
Because, I mean, the hit was well after. He wasn't carrying out a fake, so he shouldn't have been hit. It's a dirty play.
Right.
Personal foul on Ogemaw Heights.
Yep.
So Cadillac will get 15 free ones there.
You bet. You know, overall, we haven't seen a lot of penalties this evening either.
No, it's been a pretty clear, clean
it
game.
That
first drive, Ogemaw Heights jumped offside. But other than that, we haven't really seen anything.
No.
I don't know if Cadillac has gotten a penalty. Brooks set in the shotgun. One back set near him. Dual receivers both sides. Handoff. Dennis over the 40, 35, 30, 25, 20, and he's gone. Touchdown, Cadillac. No flags on the play, and Cadillac running away with it. Now it's 49-0.
Total domination.
You see right there, Dennis broke away, and nobody was going to catch him.
No, the boys got wheels.
Great job on the replay right there. 49-0 now. Just awaiting the extra point, but all Cadillac all day in this one so far.
Right now I'm sure that the Falcons are thinking about the 7 minutes and 43 seconds they've still got to suffer through before they can get back on a long bus ride back to Ogemaw Heights.
Right now they're trying to find the kicking shoe. He wears that straight-toed shoe.
Oh,
because he's a straight-on kicker, and I don't know if he had trouble getting it on or if he had trouble finding it, but they're going to run out of time here. They have to. As far as the play clock goes.
Sure.
Snap. Good one. Kick up. And the kick is good, so it's 50-0 Cadillac with 7:43 left to go here in the fourth quarter. All Vikings, like we've said, they got to be happy with this effort.
You know, there's not much more to say than it's been one-sided. It's been extremely one-sided.
Yeah, tough to hear over the band up here. It's been a while since I've been to a game. Now they turn around and play at the crowd, so it's coming right at you.
You bet.
Mr. Filkin's doing a fantastic job with the band down there. Kind of a dejected sideline over on the far side. And all smiles over here on the near side. Cadillac with a 50-0 lead over Ogemaw Heights.
I don't think it's what either coach expected for an end result this evening.
No, like we said, both teams coming in at 0-4, and you kind of thought that, you know, it's going to be a good game. Somebody's going to get their win, their first win, hard-fought game, and it's been a cakewalk for Cadillac.
Yes, it has.
Daniels set to kick off for the Vikings.
So Daniels with that special shoe will stride it back to a...
So I'm going to assume that the Falcons will bring the ball back to the 31 to...
They're actually
going to
get ahead.
Line.
35, give them the 38. Kind of a squib kick, and he brought it out to about the 38.
Yep. You know, at the same time, though, it's not their best return. Even though they've brought it back to the 38-yard line, he literally picked the ball up at the 31. So that was really a return of only about 7 yards.
No, and with a straight toe kicker, it's feast or famine.
Yep.
Either they're going to kill it or there's going to be a squib or they're not going to hit it right. I mean, it's a different way of kicking it.
Exactly.
It's the old style way. That's the way everybody used to kick.
You know, it'd be nice to see Ogemaw Heights walk out of here with at least one touchdown. It'd make for a shorter ride home, I'm sure.
It'd give you something to build on for next week.
You bet.
Hand off going right up the middle. That's number 38, Devin Christner, the ball carrier. Christner will gain about 4 yards. So 6:23, clock rolling now. Beautiful night here in northern Michigan. Yesterday, the first day of fall, I think it was yesterday. Either way, we're not that far into fall, and it still feels like late summer. It's fantastic. Hand off going right up the middle. That's Christner again. Christner will get down to about the 46-yard line.
Cadillac thought they had taken it, but the ball was called down.
they're going to be really close to a first down. From where the ref is standing, it looks like they're about a yard short.
Yeah.
A couple nice gainer plays for Ogemaw Heights.
Well, Ogemaw Heights has got 5 minutes and 40 seconds to do something if they're going to do it here in the fourth quarter.
Ostrander will come up. Dual wings either side. One goes in motion. Flag on the play. It looked like a toss play going to the far side. Illegal procedure against Ogemaw Heights.
Yeah, it looked like a false start.
That's, like I said, just shooting themselves in the foot with penalties and fumbles, and that's really cost them.
You know, it's cost them in the fact they're not able to move the ball, but there's no taking away the dominance of the Vikings this evening. You know, given all the penalties and the like, I don't think it would change the score a bit.
No, really, you're right. It wouldn't change the score at all. But, I mean, Cadillac's played probably their best game of the year.
Definitely.
Man goes in motion far side. Ostrander dropping back. Pass was skipped into his receiver. I don't think the Cadillac defender ever saw it coming.
He didn't. Matter of fact, Cadillac still had his back turned the other way when the receiver turned to pick up the ball. Sad part about it is there was no completion there.
No, he skipped the ball into him, but it'll bring up fourth and about seven. They're going to stay out here. Are they? Nope. I think they're going to punt this one away. Well, they're running people on and off. I'm confused at this point.
Well, there's one thing you don't have to be confused about, and that's who's going to win this game.
Yeah. Barring a miracle comeback.
You know, I don't think that 4 minutes, I don't think you could even perform a miracle.
They say stranger things have happened, but this would be the strangest.
Definitely.
A 50-point comeback in 4 minutes. So Ogemaw Heights is going to punt this one away. Reminder, our next game, I believe, if I'm right, October 9th, homecoming. Punt was blocked, and they actually are going to throw a flag on it. The Cadillac player got his hand on the ball, which caused it to go out of bounds, but they're going to give him a running into the kicker penalty.
Yep. Well, we definitely won't be here next week because the Vikings will be in Gaylord.
Yep, we just heard Ross saying that.
Mm-hmm.
There's a flag on the play, though, and we're going to sort this one out. Personal foul against the Vikings, running into the kicker. He got a hand on the ball. I mean, he blocked it. If you hit the ball, I'm not sure if we can get a replay on that one, but he got his hand on the ball.
Right.
And then ran into the kicker. That's legal. You're allowed to smash into the kicker if you at least catch a piece of it.
Sure.
So.
At the same time, though, you're not allowed to run into the kicker.
So Ogemaw Heights keeps the ball. It'll be first and 10 at the Cadillac 45-yard line. They are calling a personal foul, roughing the kicker. The official has motioned once again. Clock still rolling. Ogemaw Heights keeps the ball right there.
We're back in the Viking territory. 3 minutes left on the clock. Are they going to be able to do something with it?
Back goes in motion. Ostrander hands off right up the middle. It looked like that was Christner again.
Oh, was that Christner or was that
It looked like 38. Christner again. He's been kind of their go-to back between him and Cameron Diaz. Now this one just about over 2:30 left to go here in the fourth quarter.
And that clock is going to keep on running because of the point difference.
Ostrander will move up under center. Dual wings, dual receivers spread out evenly across the field. Ostrander hands up the middle, and that's Christner again. Christner will get a couple yards. He's down inside the 40 to about the 37, 36-yard line. About third and four, would you call it?
Yep. Third and four.
Falcons.
They've got less than 2 minutes to move this thing into the end zone.
Falcons wing back goes in motion. Toss goes to him on the far side. Cutting up down to the 30, 25, still on his feet. sorry, excuse me, keeps his feet moving. A flag thrown in right there. You just caught the end of it, at least it's what it looked like.
Yep.
Yep, there's the flag. We're waiting to see what the call is. I think they're going to move Cadillac back.
Flag on the play. You know, both teams, we got a minute and 30 seconds left. They started the clock back up again.
Kind of waiting to see what this one is. Personal foul face mask against Cadillac. That'll push him back even further. So we talked about not seeing any penalties for most of this game, and now we've seen a couple big ones against the Vikings.
Yep. The only saving grace for the Vikings is the clock keeps on rolling, and we're approaching the one-minute mark in this game. So that right there, that one penalty, just cost the Falcons a good 30 seconds off the clock.
So first and 10, ball on the 14-yard line. Ostrander rolling near side. He's being pressured, rolling back. He's at his 25, chucks it down. That ball ball skipped on the way in.
Looks like he scooped it off the grass.
They're going to say he caught it.
Really?
They're hustling up to the line right now, 32, 31. They're trying to get up there.
They're calling the pass complete.
They did call it complete. It looked like that ball skipped in there, but taken right up the middle. Ostrander stretches. Did he get in?
Yes.
Touchdown.
Touchdown for Ogemaw Heights. 17 seconds left on the clock, and they score their first touchdown. It's now 50-6.
Just a kind of a brutal call right there. They ran it up too fast, so we couldn't get the replay, but the ball skipped on the way in on that completion that got him down to the 5.
Definitely. So we're going to see one more kickoff. We're going to see one more kickoff from Ogemaw Heights to Cadillac. Cadillac's going to have just a couple seconds to deal with it. The clock is still going to tick.
Ostrander up under center. They're going to go for 2 here. Ostrander takes it, runs it right up the middle, and he's in for 2. So it's 50-8.
Well, this is definitely going to take that edge off, like I was saying, for the quick ride home. Clock's still ticking. This is gonna be the end of this game.
And that should do it. Clock's gonna run out.
Yep. Like to take this opportunity to, before we sign off, to thank everybody with MyNews 26 for putting 26 Sports on its inaugural broadcast this evening here with the Cadillac Vikings and the Ogemaw Heights Falcons. It's been a pleasure working with Eric Sharp. I'm Morris Langley Jr. for 26 Sports.
Still going on.
Are they going to set the clock back?
Oh, no, but they stopped it. They came over and talked. I'm sorry. They came over and talked like, hey, this game's not over yet, but that's actually going to do it. So
it is.
Continue. My bad.
No problem. Again, we are glad to be here. We'll be here again 2 weeks from now, back when the Vikings are playing against, I think it's Traverse City.
Yeah, it's Kiss Homecoming, too.
It's Kiss Homecoming. Oh, yeah. It is. We're looking forward to that. So with all of that, we want to thank you and our exclusive sponsor this evening, Cadillac Casting Incorporated, for making this happen. On behalf of 26 Sports.
Hold on.
Huh.
They actually are what? Putting 17 seconds on the clock.
They are going to put it back on.
See, the running clock
rule.
Well,
I'll tell you what. I'm going to finish signing us off so that when this does happen and it ends, we don't have to say all this again.
Okay, so how it works is 50 gets you a running clock all the time. Doesn't matter when. 35 or more gets you a running clock only until somebody scores. So somebody scores, injury, it stops. But if you have 50 or more, a lead of 50 or more, it runs all the time. Nothing can stop it. So that's why we have 17 seconds left.
Okay, so while we're putting 17 seconds back on the clock, we're going to have Ogemaw Heights kicking the ball back to the Vikings.
They got an onside kick it here.
Sure, you know they're
you
going
to. You have to.
You have to.
We will set to kick off for the Falcons.
All right. So ball teed up at the 40-yard line. Let's see if they're going to kick it deep or are they going to try the onside kick here.
I think they're going to go for the onside kick.
You have to.
Sure.
Cadillac in their base formation. Little squib kick. Taking it about the 30-yard line. 35, runs over a man, give him out to about the 40-yard line. Trying to see who was on that one.
This clock is ticking down.
Gavin Daniels,
the
kicker.
I think this is going to end it this time.
Yep, that will end it this time. So a foregone conclusion.
Yep, foregone conclusion. End score, Cadillac Vikings 50, Ogemaw Heights Falcons 8. On behalf of 26 Sports, I'm Morris Langworthy. This is Eric Sharp. Thank you for having us this evening. You guys have a wonderful evening. Hope to see you again in 2 weeks. On behalf of the Cadillac High School Athletic Department,